Talk about like the normal low speed control motion control stages. Typically, like you know, some kind of a application. So some small motion that you need in the lab kind of a level to adjust some optics or some kind of some like you know, normal motion stages. I would say microscope, you are observing something and you need to move like you know, under microscope some things. Okay, so see, those kind of motion stages, see, like you know, you typically will have make use of a screw or rack and pinion kind of arrangements. Okay, so wherever you feel like you know, there is a back travelability possibility, then like you know, you will go for the screw arrangement. Okay. And rack and pinion or those other kind of drive arrangements can be preferred where there is back drivability is not an issue. Okay, so we don't want system to be back drivable, then like you know, you use screw, because screws typically when designed properly, the screw helix angle, for some certain helix angles that are designed on the screws, they will not be back drivable. Otherwise, I mean, you see that your car jack, for example. Okay, so you raise like you know, the you tighten the screw and the car is raised up. Now see if it has been if the helix angle or that screw is not properly designed, then you know more you, even if you tighten it, like after some time, like you know, the system is going to kind of like you know, get back driven by the weight of the car itself, and it will start rotating in the opposite direction, and you lose the purpose of the jack. Okay, so screw jacks would be designed to have non-back drivability kind of arrangement, so you drive and like you know, the system stays there. It is not getting back driven by the weight of the car itself. Okay, that is a kind of a concept of back drivability here. Now let's see, how do we take care of this alignment or rather misalignment with the screw axis with the guide axis? Okay, so see, some part of this we have seen while doing like you know, our CD-ROM example. We have seen the guide there, one rod is complete guide, another rod is not so like you know, completely kind of guiding. Okay, so that is taking care of some kind of a misalignment of the two rods, guiding rods in the system. Now, if you have a screw in addition, okay, so the screw axis will have some kind of a direction for the motion. And then with respect to guide axis, you need to make sure the screw axis is aligned. And guide also needs to have like you know, two places it needs to be guided. The system cannot be guided only on one side, you know, for the reasons that it is not fully constrained then. Okay, so you need to have typically two guiding places for the motion, for the linear motion to happen. And along with that, you have now the screw arrangement that is going to be there. So how do you think like you know, this system can be what kind of arrangement can be done to take care of this issue? How this misalignment when you are driving with the screw is taken care of? Okay, so think about that, and we'll talk about that in a while now. And another issue that one can think is like you know, how to get like you know, low resolution over large range. Again here, when you are using some kind of a screw kind of a drive, to get low resolution, I mean extremely like you know, your resolution, I mean the resolution should be high in actually. Low resolution is not a correct word to use here. It's a high resolution means like you need a very tight motion tolerances here. You want to kind of move maybe say 5 micron or 10 micron, okay. And you need to have that over the larger range, you want to kind of like maintain that kind of a high resolution. How do you get that when the screw drive is there? So typically, when you see the screw car jack kind of a stuff, those screws, would it be helpful in here? Okay, or any kind of screw you might have seen. Okay, screw and nut arrangement, you imagine. Okay, you have a nut and screw arrangement, and like now you see how loosely the nut moves on the screw. And if you just hold the screw tight and move the nut in the axial direction, okay, then you'll find that there is some kind of a play that will happen. Okay, so you have a screw and a nut together, and then you just move it, and like now you'll see that there is a play that can happen there. So under this scenario, like now you will again need some kind of a backlash prevention. So this is like a backlash arrangement, right? You move in one direction and it touches one side of the screw threads, and in the other direction, other side of the screw threads. But now we know we have this screw as a complete circular screw there, and the nut also is a complete circular nut there. So how can we think of the some of the ideas that we had with the CD-ROM screw? Okay, in the CD-ROM screw, you remember, like, you had these two stubs which were kind of pressing against the screw. Now we have, say, single nut. Okay, what we can do? So you might guess that, okay, look, you need to have some kind of a preload somewhere, like, some kind of a the loading of the screw nut against the screw should happen somehow. Okay, so if that is happening, then I'll have this application going good. Okay, and that's precisely he's done. See, if you just use stubs here, stubs kind of a thing for the screw, then this may have a load bearing capacity will be reduced. Okay, the small stubs may not be able to carry very large load if you want to drive really a good load when you move the screw typically. So imagine in the car jack, you cannot have stubs which are holding the screw there. I know that, so that kind of a weight of the car cannot be taken by just small stubs which are up there. In fact, in there, your screw will have many more threads engaged at a time, okay, rather than only single thread engaged at a time, single or two threads engaged at a time. Okay, so we want this total circular kind of a engagement to happen, but still we want to kind of do some kind of a preloading of the screw. So how do we do that? Okay, so let's see some actual motion kind of a stage systems. This is one of the motion stage systems from this company called Hallmark. Okay, so if you open up this, okay, so this is a screw. You can see this is like a you have a micrometer screw gauge kind of a screw there, and it is pushing this this stage, okay, on which you can mount whatever things that you want to move. And as I tighten this screw, this will push this stage, but then this engagement here, the screw threads are in this piece, okay. And then the stage is just guided in the linear fashion here by some bearings up here and here. So there are two side guides here for the screw. As we open up, we'll see these details. But the screw is in here. Okay, so screw is not attached to the stage. Okay, so that is how one can say that the guides axis and the screw axis is made free. So this screw is just touching up here. Okay, so you can open up and see here. Okay. So this is a screw here. A screw has no, the threads are in this piece, okay, and then this is a screw, okay, and the screw has this small kind of a piece that is coming out and touching and pushing this this up, upper stage. This is upper stage, and you can see these two little springs here. The springs are tensioned, and they are attached to this bottom piece. Bottom piece is where here this screw is assembled on the bottom piece here. So when you tension these springs and attach it to the bottom piece, there is a relative kind of a pull between this top and the bottom piece in this direction, okay? And this screw is actually preventing that pull to happen, okay? So as I tighten the screw, I'll push this more and more, and like the pushing force is going to get increased because the springs are getting tensioned more and more, okay? And as I like now loosen the screw, I mean push it, then the spring is moving the stage, okay? The screw is just like releasing the position of the head, screw head, relatively, okay? So the screw is head position is moved relatively, and then the stage gets pushed by the springs which are pre-tensioned here. This is how you create this preload in the system and move the system such that the motion happens in both the directions. So the push is an active motion by the screw, but pull is happening here because of the springs. That is how the things happen. So what are the problems for such an arrangement? You can imagine and see that if I have a force which is much more than the spring force, okay, at any point, then in the appropriate direction, in the direction say in this case against losing the contact or in the direction of losing the contact between the screw and where it touches. So the place where it touches is somewhere on this somewhere here, okay? So you see this little kind of a pin or something here. This is a very hard surface on which this head will be touching. So so this if I apply a force in this direction, then the touch will be lost, okay, and by my force. So there is no active thread engagement which will hold it firmly there, okay? This force is applied and it goes against some threads, to and the threads will take a weight and not allow us to move. That kind of a thing will not happen. So this will allow that motion to happen if that force is much higher. Depending upon application, where you want to use, you need to think carefully about whether this is okay for your application or not, and take a decision, take a call about that. What little things that you see here are basically the bearings. There are these two bearings on each side, or maybe many more, maybe on each side. And then there is this guide which will have these bearings put there, and there will be some kind of a small adjustment for these guide rods. These are guide rods which are placed here in some cavity, and those guide rods will have some kind of adjusting grub screws that are put inside this piece, okay? So those adjusting grub screws will make sure that the both sides are aligned to each other, okay, so that there is no jam in the bearing, so that some kind of a skilled operation needs to be done initially to engage these two together and make sure that these bearings are guiding in such a way that over entire motion there is no jam that is happening and there is no play that is happening also. So that kind of a skilled operation needs to be done to begin with, because now here we don't have full guide on one side and half guide on the other side. That arrangement could also have been made here, possibility is there, but here that has the load bearing capacity will be lesser in that case. Load bearing capacity in such a kind of a guide is better typically. But then it comes at a cost of doing this additional adjustment of these both the side guides, such that there is no jamming that will happen, as you would kind of imagine. Otherwise, if these are not aligned properly, then there is a possibility of jamming that will happen for the stage. Okay, so so this is typically the arrangement for the motion stages. Now we want to as you see here, as I move more and more, okay, the springs are getting stretched more and more. Then, like, you know, the amount of force in the springs will increase as they stretch more and more. So, which is not really desirable, right? I mean, then that means, like, you know, I'm kind of restricted to a small range of motions with these kind of stages. I cannot move a very large motion because my spring is going to apply a very large force at one end and, like, you know, a relatively smaller force at the other end of the stage. And that's how, like, you know, the force will vary along the length of the stage. So for that I'll need to do something. Okay, so think of what arrangement can we do to get rid of this issue. That, okay, large range, even if I move whatever large range I want to move, this problem will not bother me. But I'll still have, like, you know, some arrangement for, you know, the misalignment of the axis of the screw and guide axis. Okay, so guide axis will be adjusted by these guides in some way. So the guide axis will be defined by the guides. And now in this case, if you see the screw axis, the guide axis is, like, you know, tilted with respect to the screw axis, it's not going to create a major issue. Okay, because there is a relative kind of a sidewise motion that will happen at this contact point. Okay, so contact point is so as I tighten and, like, you know, the guides suppose go in one kind of tilted direction, and then screw is going in other direction. But since there is no firm engagement of the screw, there is only, like, you know, pushing contact there. The push can be kind of move slightly on the surface of the of these you know, things that is getting pushed. Okay, so there is a relative sidewise motion that can be possible between the surface that is getting pushed, the stage that is getting pushed, and the screw motion. So that's how, like, you know, this alignment misalignment problem is taken care of, and then backlash problem is taken care of by the spring. But what problem I invite by using this is, like, you know, if I have to kind of if I want to go for larger range, the spring force will increase tremendously high, and I'll need more kind of a effort to move against the larger force of the spring. And typically, if I have a motor to drive this, then the motor will see this differential load. Like, okay, depending upon the position of the stage, I'll have a load that I need to apply because the friction will change at different points. So these are the kind of typically drawbacks. So nothing is free. If you want to take care of the backlash, you put some load, preload, then, like, you know, the load on the motor is going to increase. More the preload, like, you know, better kind of a system you may get, but that much more kind of a torque or friction torque that one has to overcome to drive my system. Okay, no? So these are the kind of, like, you know, issues that come up, and, like, you know, this is a way things could be designed to get them working. So you can think, like, you know, how do you achieve larger kind of designs? And if you have some kind of ideas, thought, then, like, you know, you can move on from there. Okay, you can pause again at this point and then let's move on. So this is, like, you know, an arrangement for the larger kind of a range positioning without having now these two big kind of a springs there. So you see this in this arrangement, again, like, you know, this is opened up stage. What you observe here is this is a nut cage here. This is not like a single nut. I'll show you what is there inside in a minute. But this is some kind of arrangement here. So imagine that, okay, this had been only the nut. Okay, there's no some kind of arrangement. This is just like a nut here. And then the top, there are four screws which are, like, you know, attached to this stage that moves on the surface. And then there are these guide rod here and guide rail here. These are two guide rails here and here, and they'll have some kind of a, you know, limit switches that they have put here for, like, you know, knowing the limits of the thing so that you can turn off the motor. So this is already motor mounted here. This is motor driven stuff. There is a, you can see here, there is a flexible coupling. And then all this arrangement is there. So when it is assembled, it looks like this. When it is opened, like, you know, the top stage is these bearings are open, then, like, you know, you get this kind of a view. Okay, and then there is a screws. Typically, the screws are with a very fine threads. So the fine threads mean they'll not be pack drivable. And for a large motion of the rotation, you'll get very small motion of the screw, so that it will have a very high positioning accuracy can be possible. Okay, so for one step of the motor, you'll get a very tiny motion that is happening for the stage. Given that, we don't have a backlash issues, and given that we don't have a misalignment issues. So see this axis of this screw and the guide axis. Again, there might be possibility that okay, they may get small misalignment, and then you'll see that the screw will get jammed in no time if there is no special arrangement that is done inside this. So think about what kind of arrangement can be there inside this to take care of these two problems. One is like a backlash. Another is your misalignment of the guide axis and the screw axis. And if you open up further, you'll get this kind of a thing. Now, so you see this is a part here, and then this is a part here opened up. Like inside that, this is a nut. Okay, so this is only the nut, and then this is some kind of a cage around the nut. Okay, so this cage has this typical construction. Like, okay, it's a C kind of a cage, and inside there is a hole here, and there is a hole on the other side, and nut is slid inside. And now you can imagine. So now you can imagine if this axis of the screw and axis of the guide has small misalignments or small tilt. Okay, then the screw is going to move inside the cage, but the cage is attached to the top thing, which is guided. So the cage is guided by these two side rails, which is attached to this piece here, which is a stage motion stage, which is guided by these two side guides. So the axis of this is this cage is moving along one axis, and then this is moving along say another axis, and then there is a relative motion that is created between these two, because this is just sliding inside this. Okay, so this is arrangement that is made to make sure that your misalignment of this axis is taken care of. And then you see small little kind of a holes here. Okay, these holes, if you see carefully, I mean they are not there here, but you can imagine that these holes, one can put springs there. When you are put springs in these holes here, there they are pressed against this top. So I have to kind of really push this and put springs in pre-compression to align the hole of the nut to the hole of this cage to kind of get the screw inside the nut. Okay, so that will make sure that I have some kind of a preloading of the screw done. Okay, so nut with respect to screw is getting preloaded on the surface, and whether the nut is here or here or here or here, no, any position I put this cage, the spring load is not going to change, right? So this is how one takes care of solving the problem of misalignment also, and having now the we have removed those big springs that were causing us the increase of the force. Okay, so this is how the things are done here. Maybe it's a good point, we can pause here, and we have so these are more kind of a pictures that you can see for this arrangement of the guide. So you can see that here there are 45 degree cuts made in the guides, and then the small little boy bearings that are actually the cylindrical rollers, which are put inside this to make sure that this is guided. And then there are some kind of adjustment screws that are provided at the back here for the alignment of both the guides to be done. Okay, so we can kind of pause here for the discussion, and then we'll move discuss little thing more in the other class. But these are kind of a summer salient features or summary of things that we have done today. Okay, so for removing backlash, you do some kind of arrangement. For removing, like maintaining the parallel axis motion with the misalignment problem is taken care of by some kind of arrangement. So one can do this kind of designs thinking and affect the design in such a way that you don't have to do a lot of drudgery in control domain. Okay, so these are all these kind of things are done to make sure you have no pains in motion, actually having the motion, and also you'll have a little bit of ease in driving the systems in the electronics domain. And I would like to think, would like you to think about, okay, now what is the cost that we are paying for putting these spring loading things in the on the electronics side. Okay, so think about that.